The Axioline F station consists of a bus coupler for IEC 61850, a relay output module and a binary input module. Read in the local bus of the station first. The LED PP indicates that the bus coupler is in plug and play mode. That means that the I/O configuration is being read in. Change to normal operation via the rotary switch in positions 1 and B. The device must always be restarted in order to take on changed settings. Do this either by switching off the supply voltage or simply with the reset button. Do this simply with the reset button. This is located beneath the top marking label. Press the reset button briefly. The bus coupler restarts. To communicate with the station, the IP address is first set with the two rotary coding switches, S1 and S2, on the front side of the bus coupler. Bring the switches to positions 0 and 1 for the IP address 192.168.0.1. The station must now be restarted. The red LED IED indicates that there is not yet any IEC 61850 configuration on the device. This is transferred from the PC onto the device via FTP. Use the File Explorer to access the file system of the bus coupler. Enter the address of the FTP server in the address line. This is composed of the abbreviation FTP and the IP address of the bus coupler. In this way, you access the root directory of the bus coupler, and subsequently, with a double click, the directory IEC 61850. The required configuration file is located in the already open project directory and is transferred via FTP by drag and drop to the file system of the bus coupler. Start a browser to continue configuration of the device. The IP address of the bus coupler is entered in the address line. The device responds by opening the start page. Open the item SAS configuration under the category IEC 61850. Make entries on the configuration used here. The file name of the configuration file is substation1.scd. The name of the IED is IED1. The access point is called Access Point 1. The entries for the names are case sensitive. The settings are taken on after entering the password and restarting. Assign the IEC objects to the terminal blocks of the I/O modules under the item I/O mapping. The 4-channel relay module is defined under GGI01. To assign the signals, press the Add button. Afterwards, the IEC 61850 attribute control value is selected and assigned the output module and channel. GGI02 describes the 16-channel input module. To assign the signals, press the Add button each time. Afterwards, the IEC 61850 attribute status value is selected. And assign the input module and channel. Mapping is concluded when the password is entered and the bus coupler restarted. The final step is to set the IP address of the time server in the network under the item SNTP. And to confirm again with the password. The green LED IED indicates that a final configuration has been loaded. The station is now ready for operation and can be run in an IEC 61850 network.